there is one thing I like more than luxury items, it's getting a discount. I've always been that sort of person. I love something even more when I know that I've got a discount on it, even if it's 10%. I'm going to share with you my top tips on how I save money on luxury items. I have got right now on the floor around me an array of items, including, I didn't know I had this many. I think I've got like 5 Balmain blazers. I'm gonna share with you the whole thing, how I do it. And I thought this would be quite fun as well because it might give you some ideas. This video is in really proud collaboration with ShopTagger, who I've worked with twice before, so you're probably familiar with them. ShopTagger are an app. Now this is how I use it and this is how I get the discounts. You can download the app to your phone, but it also goes on your desktop computer, and that's probably where I use it the most, I would say. It's really simple to use. Once you've created the account, ShopTagger will guide you on how to implement the little clicky button, the icon that goes in the browser. It works on Louis Vuitton, it works on Luisa Via Roma, Mytheresa, Net-a-Porter, all of the places that you can go to for designer. It's really simple. You click the icon, you can then create lists if you want to. So for example, for me, I like to have a separate list for shoes and bags, as I do for clothing. And that's just so that when I'm looking through things, I haven't got to look through, because my list is quite long, I haven't got to look through something like this. I can just like break it down by categories. If the item you want is out of your size, it will alert you if it comes back in. Furthermore, if that retailer ever releases a coupon code, it tells you straight away. We've got Cyber Weekend coming up, and this is the reason why you need to get on it. When those coupon codes start coming out and when the sales start, any items that you have got bookmarked, ShopTagger will contact you immediately via email and it will tell you. I bought this pair of Miu Miu shoes last year. I wanted them so badly. They were around about £680 and I wasn't prepared to pay that for them. I held out, and they eventually went on sale on Net-a-Porter, and there was one pair in my size, and I only got it because I got that email the minute they went on sale, and I was straight there and I bought them, and they sold out because I had that last pair. So that's the primary thing that I personally use to get these discounts. It lets you get in there first and get the discount in question. But the other thing you need to do, and I mentioned their Cyber Weekend. Cyber Weekend is at the end of November, and pretty much everywhere does crazy sales, and there will be flash coupons that come out. I know Luisa Via Roma do them, and it will be like, this flash coupon is only going to last for the next half an hour, and if there are things you want, you need to be ready to jump on it. So start creating a wish list now. It's also a really good way. How many of us browse around the internet and you're looking at things and you're like, yeah, I like that, but I don't know if I want to buy that just yet, or I want to see if there's something better. And then very often when you're trying to remember, what was that dress the other day that I saw, and you can't remember where you saw it, this is a great way of you storing everything in one place. Some of you, I don't know if you follow me on Instagram. If you don't, you should. Because I put on there, particularly on my Instagram stories, I put lots of just mini reviews. I make things, like for example, my illuminated mirror. I made that and I showed you how I do it. But also I show you how to get designer discounts. And a couple of weeks ago, I was in Dior and a load of you went mental when I shared this. If you are particularly into a brand, if that designer brand has got a menswear line, check out the menswear line, ladies. Normally, women's wear is crazy money. Then you go and look at the men's stuff and it's less than half price. This here is a scarf from Christian Dior. It's £370. This is a men's scarf. It's made out of wool. It's super size. It's lovely. The equivalent scarf in women's wear is £1,600. How disgusting is that price difference? So if you want that Dior look, or if you want Givenchy, Yves Saint Laurent, any of those brands that have menswear lines, go and check it out. Because men, they don't shop. Designers know that, so they make their prices less. Moving on to coupon codes. You can save quite a lot if you sign up to individual newsletters. And the most common one that I talk about is Luisa Via Roma. They do some incredible coupon codes. You can either sign up to their newsletter, or if you have that ShopTagger app that I mentioned earlier, you don't really need to because they tell you about it anyway in real time. But talking about coupon codes, You know those coupon code websites? You've got a load of stuff in your basket on a website and you're like, I want to see if there's a live coupon. You go onto Google, you're typing in, is there a coupon code live at the moment for my Teresa? Those places to get coupon codes, normally the codes are way out of date because they're just there to get a bit of money off you. The best way to get coupon codes are in those two ways that I mentioned. ShopTagger, but also sign up to retailers' newsletters. There are many retailers that as soon as you go onto the website, a message will pop up and it'll be like 10% off just for you if you sign up to our newsletter. The places that I tend to buy from are Vestiaire Collective. Yeah, you know, I've heard some stories about them and I bought something once and the only thing I could complain about is it took a very long time to get the item because the seller was taking her time to send it to Vestiaire Collective. But if you can buy something on there, you know it's the real thing. You can get it for such a good price. Rewards programs can be a really good way to get a discount that's actual cash kind of thing. So what I mean by this is, if you shop from Harrods, let's say, Harrods have got the Harrods Rewards scheme, which is really good. Another place that has a rewards program are Louisa Via Roma. So that's another reason why I shop from them quite a lot, because that really adds up as well. The more you spend on there, the points convert really quickly too. A lot of places make you wait, like Harrods. If you're in the green or the gold tier, I think you've got to wait a year. When you're black tier, you can change your points whenever you want. But Louisa Via Roma, it converts the points quite quickly. I think it's after like 30 days or something. Currency differences, who would have known it? Think about this. You are in the UK. For us at the moment, we're a bit screwed actually when it comes to currency. But a couple of years ago, probably more than that, 2013, I bought myself, where are they? I don't know where the other one is. I bought this pair of shoes. These are the Valentino Rock Stud shoes. Maybe in 2014 I bought them. And I bought them from Farfetch. Now at the time, Farfetch works by sourcing products from boutiques all over the world. And at the time, these were sourced from a boutique in Italy. And because the price was in euro and the pound was stronger than the euro, these were at the time £500 or £600. I got them for £340. I felt like I had robbed the shop. And I got them for that price because the currency in pounds was so strong against the euro. The other thing that I did that meant that I got them for this price is Farfetch do a 10% off your first order. You've got to be shifty about this, but you can definitely get the money off. Be careful with Farfetch though. A lot of the stuff on there is extortionately priced. I do not know why. Some things like this are really cheap and other things are like more than double what they actually are in the shop. So make sure you do your research. Don't jump in there too fast and buy it. Double check what the prices are elsewhere. Get to know a sales associate, if possible. And I know this won't be possible for everyone because if you don't live near a place where there is your favorite shop, whether it's Louis Vuitton or Chanel or Dior or Hermes or whatever it may be, if you don't live near a place, this can be quite difficult. But let me just explain why it's quite helpful. First of all, when there's a new collection that launches, they're the first people to send you pictures on WhatsApp of the items, giving you first dibs on everything that's just come out. That, my friends, is how I bought the purple iridescent boy Chanel in 2015. That bag was rarer than I don't know what. You just couldn't get it, but I only got it because I had a sales associate at the time that knew I wanted it. And he was like, if I get it in, I will put it aside for you. And he did, and I had to go in that day and buy it, but I was like, I will cancel all my plans to get this bag. The other great reason why it's really good to get to know a sales associate is places like Chanel, places like Dior. These places have sales, okay? They normally have two a year. One is in the summer, at the end of June, beginning of July, and the other one is at the end of December, kind of into January a bit. These stores don't make it public knowledge. Normally, for premium customers, they will let you know that a sale has launched before they make it publicly aware. But if you get to know a sales associate, they will let you know of the pre-sale. I think I recorded this back in the summer. My sales associate at Dior told me Dior sale's going on today, but it's secret, no one knows about it. Come in, there's like a whole private area that's got all the stuff in it. You get first pickings on everything that's there. And I went towards the end of the private sale and there was already like nothing in it. I got a really nice dress in it. That's why when you go to the main sales, you're like, what is this stuff? It's in weird sizes, weird colors, weird designs. It's because all of the good stuff already got taken by people that were in the know. So try and build up that relationship. A lot of sales associates are getting a lot better at this. I went into a store in a Chanel store in Monaco. I didn't even buy anything, but the lady that I was talking to wrote her personal number on a card for me and was like, if there's anything you want, let me know. So a lot more places are getting into it. If you're serious about buying something, but you didn't buy something on that particular day, I don't think that should put you off. I think you can tell someone who's genuine from someone who isn't ever going to buy anything. They just want to kind of like waste your time a bit. I would just talk to the sales associate and say, look, would it be possible to get your details? And then you can send me pictures of anything new that comes in. Basket abandonment. Who knew this was a thing? Try this. Doesn't work everywhere, but it works in a lot of places. Go on to your favorite store, add a load of stuff to your basket, log in so they know who you are, and then leave. Very often you'll get an email, not from everyone, but you'll get an email saying, you left all your stuff in your basket, here's 10% off to make you go and buy it. Try it. It's getting less and less that that happens now. That used to happen all the time on ASOS. Myself and my friends, if we were like picking an outfit to go out in the evening in, everyone just knew, right, put it in your basket, log in, and then just clear off for like an hour or so. They'll be begging you to come back. That used to happen all the time, but some places still do it. And a lot of places, when you get to their website, will do that thing where they'll pop-up message will come up and they'll automatically offer you 10% if you let them have your email address. This is the total amount that I've ever saved to date on all of this stuff. And it makes me feel so good. But also, one of the really good things is very often when I buy things, I will sell them after I've use them, or I want to get something else, I'll use the money from them to buy the next thing that I want. And when you buy something for a discount, it gives you a bit of room when it comes to margin, because if the person you're selling to wants a discount and you've bought it for a discount, it gives you that room to play with. So it's just quite nice, really. I've linked to everything below, including the ShopTagger app. Remember, honestly, if you are planning on buying anything for Cyber Weekend, or if there's anything in your mind that you think you want, create a wish list. It's gonna help you so much.